All right, it's Thursday, and it's back to school for most kids across the province. Nice shot there of downtown Vancouver. It's going to be another hot one, and the little ones are on their way. For more on this, we're joined by Liza Yuzda from News 1130. Good morning to you. Lots to chat about today.
A lot, yes. Yeah. Good morning, Thor.
Good morning. Okay, so let's get the sense. You're hearing from teachers, and there's a wide range of opinions about going back to school with the concerns.
This week, I mean, and leading into this week, I've been talking to a lot of teachers, and it really does run the gamut. I've talked to ones that are like fine. They said, you know, they actually were more relieved when they got back into school and saw how their school was going to deal with it, getting kids in and out of school, how their class was going to look like. There are other teachers who have said, you know, that they are terrified. One telling me that their plan for today was to make sure that they had an appointment with a psychiatrist to talk about what they're describing as paralyzing anxiety. So it really is the gamut. And I think that, you know, heading into any unknown, this is going to be the case. Some are concerned about things not being set up well enough. Some are concerned that there's no physical way to set up well enough to protect themselves and the students. So they're going to have to make a difference of do they protect themselves and give themselves space at the front of the room or spread the kids out. I think we just need to wait and see and get in there and trust that this will work out. We know there's a lot of areas of the province where the cases are exceptionally low. And Dr. Bonnie Henry telling us that overall, compared to other places in the country, you know, and other places in the world, Canada is doing very well. So it's quite confident in our plan and in the ability to contact trace should anyone have a case.
All right. And speaking of Dr. Bonnie Henry, the provincial government outlining the fall pandemic plan yesterday. Give us some of the details with respect to the regional approach, flu season coming with immunizations and surgeries as well.
One of the key things that I heard out of it was this regional approach. You know, when we saw things happen and things pull back in the spring, it was carte blanche across BC. We saw hospitals emptied out across BC. We saw surgeries canceled across BC. Heading into the fall and winter, it will be regional. It'll be according to the demands and needs of that area. So if they're, and they're expecting Metro Vancouver to be the hardest hit area, they will see, you know, pullbacks and perhaps having to minimize some surgeries there in order to fill up the hospital beds. That's the worst case scenario. But we're looking pretty good for the amount of space to help mitigate that issue of keeping space open. You mentioned flu. We're heading into flu season.
Right.
They are pushing this year for what Dr. Bonnie Henry said will be a flu vaccination campaign like the province has never seen before. They've ordered 450,000 more vaccine doses. That's about 2 million in total. 45,000 for these special ones that they give to seniors that are sort of souped up flu zone vaccines. They're wanting as many people as possible to get this vaccination, not only because it protects us and will keep people out of hospitals from flu, but also it will minimize the guesswork when people do become ill of, is this flu? Is this COVID-19? So they're really encouraging people to get out, make time to get flu vaccines when they're available, and that will happen in about October, November this year.
All right, I want to talk to mom now as we close it out. You have your daughter going into grade 4, your son starting kindergarten. How are you feeling this morning?
I'm really quite nervous. Like, I know all the things. I've listened to all these press conferences since, you know, February. I trust that the process would not be in place if it wasn't by and large safe, but I'm a parent. You know, we've had our kids at home, and I think I mentioned this last week, but there's a little bit of us that's like, oh my gosh, let's get them gone so we can get back to like normal schedule. And then there's part of you that just wants to hold on, but I'm taking deep breaths. I'm trusting the process. And it's all going to be great.
Okay, you got this, Liza. Just breathe and remember. It's going to be okay.
Thanks,
all right, thanks for checking in with us. We appreciate your time today.
Oh, my pleasure. Have a great day.
All right, good luck. That's News 1130's Liza Yuzda. And coming up in...